Hey, welcome back to the Six Figure Mastermind. Marianne, the novelist here, and today we're talking Mailchimp. And you want to know how to send bulk emails with Mailchimp? I'm going to walk you through it A to Z, so stay tuned. Okay, so we're going to talk bulk email campaigns, and we're going to do this right here live with you and me, so you can do it right alongside me. So go ahead and open up another browser, go to Mailchimp, Mailchimp.com, get yourself logged in, and you're going to see my screen look exactly like yours. Okay, now that we've got my screen open, we're going to do the first thing right here is called create a campaign. When you're sending out a bulk email, Mailchimp has its own term for it. It's called a campaign. So when you click create campaign, that's going to get you started. What I love about Mailchimp is that they've got templates galore. So if you need to send out a newsletter, if you need to send out a post, if you need to send out a blog share, whatever it is, they've got some kind of a cool template for that, even if it's for a sales conversation or a clearance you've got going on. So this is what it's going to show you. It's going to say, what do you want to create? Do you want to create an email, create an ad, create a landing page? It's got the step-by-step walkthrough. Well, let's just go through email right now. First thing it's going to ask you for is the campaign name. Now, this isn't something that your mailing list is going to see. This is just for you. So name it whatever you want. You can say, what I love to do is tag my campaign so I can check my analytics later. So I'll put the date down. I'll say maybe it's June 4th. I'm sending out a campaign for clearance. Clearance ad. 75% off necklaces. Okay, maybe that's for my small business or whatever it is. Just name it so that you know what it is, so when you go back and check your analytics later, meaning that when you want to know how many people opened it, how many people looked at it, how many people actually clicked the follow-through links, you know which email it generated from. Again, your customers are not going to see this. Okay, so then I'm going to click begin. All right, the first thing it's going to do is walk you through what this email is going to do and who it's going to go to. So the first thing it's going to ask is, who are you sending this campaign to? You're going to click Add Recipients. Now, this is really helpful when you already have your list built into Mailchimp. So I can choose a list, a subcategorized list. I can choose all the lists. But make sure that when you have this up and running, that you've already got your lists exported from your whatever document or CRM that you're using and thrown into Mailchimp. So I can select a list here from any of my lists. I've got a bridal store I used to do some joint ventures with. I've got, you know, all of these different lists that I've built. So I can say, okay, I want this to go to this specific list, okay? And I can sub-segment out this new list too. So let's say that you have a list of people and they're constantly subscribing because you've got an opt-in on your landing page and you want to send out a new email to your new subscribers. Well, you can do that here. Pre-built, you can put new subscribers. You can put female, male, under 25, 35 and over. This is a great targeting option so that you can get really specific with the people that are actually going to read this email. So I'm just going to say for this one, since it's just a clearance and announcement to everybody, I would say all subscribers on list. Again, if you were doing something more specific, pick a more specific niche in your categorizing. Personalize the to field, meaning it's going to personalize their name. Now, you got to be careful with this one because if you personalize the to field, you can say, yeah, I want it to be their F name, which is their first name or last name or whatever you pick. However, if your list doesn't have their first name in it, it's going to show that asterisk bar F name bar asterisk in the email itself. All right? So only use that if you know you have everyone's first name. If not, ignore it. Don't personalize that to field because then it won't feel awkward. All right, click save. And who is sending this campaign? A lot of people that use Mailchimp have several businesses or several lists that they run. So you can add who this is coming from. So I can have it be my name. I can have it be the email address. Let's say you've got multiple businesses, maybe under an LLC, and you're wanting to come send an email from support. You can change that here. You can change it to support@yourbusiness.com or maybe announcements@yourbusiness.com. If you want it to come from the CEO, you can say CEO or better yet, the CEO's name at whatever your business is. So you can specify who this is coming from, especially when you're sending out a brand new email to a brand new list and they want to know where it's coming from so they don't just dump it in the spam. Use that box, especially this name box over here. So I'm going to say it's coming from me. Good to go there. the subject. The subject line for this campaign will be seen by the people opening up these emails. So you can do a couple things with your subject. You know, I always like to put emojis in my subject. They're very popular nowadays. How do I write a good subject line? You can get some advice there. You can do a preview text. This is super helpful because not all emails will show you the entirety of your subject line. So you want to make sure that when you send out a good subject line, that it's really condensed well in the preview of their email. Okay. So I'm going to say something like, open this up. You don't want to miss this sale. See inside for more great deals. Now I'm making this extra long on purpose so that you can see what the snippet text will say. This snippet text will show you, okay, I'm gonna make this preview text separate from this. So I'm gonna say, this preview says And the editor's gonna go back for me and just go back to this snippet text. Okay, this snippet text, this preview text, is what will appear in the inbox after the subject line. So you've got your big subject line, and then you've got your follow-up teaser right here. So I could even say, see inside for more great deals. I could copy that and move it over and say, that's what I want to have them see. And I'll put a little ellipse after that and call it good. Okay, I'm going to save that, move on to content. This is the fun part. This is where you get to totally get creative, okay? We're going to design this email. Now, MailChimp is super cool because they've got all of these different templates, all of these different ideas. You can kind of get a feel for what your email is going to look like. You can tell us, you know, just they call these different things, make an appointment, announcement, tell a story, follow up, different things that you want to do. You can even go over here to themes and create a theme for yours. Very, very fun. They've got some clip art that you can use. You can go over to saved templates. Maybe you've got one of these before that you've used. Campaigns that you use. You can code your own if you're into coding. That's not me. I like to just go with a simple layout. So let's just go with a simple layout right here. I'm going to say make an announcement. Perfect for announcing a sale. All right, we get over here into our design. Now, the design, you can modify it however you want, or you can just leave it as is with the pictures where they are, with the descriptions where they are. Now, I'm not gonna take the time to go through and design a whole email with you today because that's gonna, you know, require photos and images and texts and copy and all of that. That's totally up to you. Once you have that all filled out, or let's say you wanna change a couple images, you've got some space to do that here. So when you click on that image and click this little pencil, you can edit this block. And when you edit that block, you can add images to that block. You can add images that you've saved from other campaigns. MailChimp does you a huge favor, and every time you upload an image to MailChimp, they save it for you in case you want to use it. So for instance, your logo, you don't want to have to upload that every single time. You want to do some trust icons like PayPal or Visa or whatever it is. You don't want to have to upload that every single time. So they save it for you. And when you build a really cool template, you can just go to the template and then you won't have to design it all over again every time. Okay, so let's just say we've got your copy in there, you've got your images in there, you've got your links in there. Everything's all built and put together. You've edited all your blocks, all your buttons are working, you can test it out. It's time to save and close. Okay, first we're going to click that, and then we're going to click save and close right over here. Okay, it's going to take this back to this page. Now, since we didn't fill in the content, it's giving us a little red X here. Yeah, we detect that your default content is your email is not in there. Don't worry about that. You'll have content in yours, and that won't be a problem. Okay, and even to test, I can't stress how important this is. When you have that ready to go, there's a little link down here that says send a test email. Please, for the love of all things business, click send a test email and send it to yourself and check your links, check your spelling, check your photos, check your layout, double check it, triple check it as much as you need to so that when your email goes out to your public, it's exactly what you want it to be. Always, always, always send a test email. Once your test email has gone through and you're liking it, once you've got all your social media links on there, you've got your Twitter, you're linked, you got your Facebook linked, you got your Instagram linked, you got your YouTube link, all of that is in there and you feel like everything's working and ready to go, then you're going to go over to this button and click send. Now let me show you what that looks like. Okay, perfect. Now that we've resolved our content issues, you've resolved all the red flags, all the red X's, everything's pretty ready to go. This is one of my favorite parts of MailChimp because they're super fun. Okay, I'm going to click send. Remember, only do this after you have tested the email first. You're going to click send, all right? This is where it gets really, really exciting, okay? So you've got this like monkey ready to click the send button. Now, I'm not going to send this because this isn't a fully filled out email, but I've got 367 subscribers that would get this test email if I were to click send right now. Once you click send right now, this is your moment of glory. It's going to go straight out to all your subscribers, and it's going to be a great email campaign. Now, that's basically it. When you get your emails ready to go through MailChimp, if you find that you've got one that you're going to be using repeatedly, let's say that you do more than one clearance sale in the lifetime of your business, really good idea to save it as a template. If you've got any announcements that you want to make, or especially a newsletter that you know is going to be repeating going out, save that as a template. Save yourself some time. Create that system for yourself. But that's basically it. MailChimp is super, super easy to use. Hey, what else do you need to know about MailChimp? Leave me a comment below, drop me a line, hit the subscribe button, and do me a favor, ring the bell so you get notified when our video comes out tomorrow. I'll see you then.